Oh man. Yeah. Ring. Okay, that is not the ring we've come to know and love. That is not creepy at all. It's like, oh, I was in a sci-fi movie for a second. Sci-fi Channel original production.
Big old smile on her face, just happy.
Why so serious?
Oh, I was passed out? This program, what was that about Ring? It's just a game. Really, Jack should hold off on his jokes once in a while. Like, what are you talking?
Why Jack?
Jack? Sheesh. Now I have to give a piece of my mind. It's like you went into a whole other reality, and she's like, oh, it's just a game.
Yeah.
Hello?
Oh, I don't remember that happening before.
Hello?
Do you remember that happening before?
Yeah.
Okay.
Dead.
Stupid. Like a whole animation about it.
Seven more days. Power outage, a prank call, and a weird program. 7 more days. I'm gonna die in 7 days?
Nobody said that.
You have got to be kidding.
I've gotta be kidding. I just paid off my mortgage.
Alright, so what if I click on the phone again?
That won't detect, talk, tell Jack something. Oh well. If only this thing called out.
You should read the floor.
Oh, just sit there and do that.
Alright, so we're gonna get out of Meg's office now, and an hour later, we finally get to move on.
But the chief told her to stay put. Not to mention the animation on these guys. It's like the Rock Auto commercial. Have you seen that?
No.
Rock Auto? But I can get all my parts by going to Rock Auto.
That's
You're
funny.
Not selling your action figures?
No.
Oh no!
Funny too, like the way she's dressed. It's like, actually, we're playing as one of the hookers from the Grand Theft Auto game.
Yeah, probably.
Alright, so here's another box. Oh, yeah, look at this. You hit start. Let's look. Okay, we still got our gun and everything, right?
Nope. Not in reality.
You got nothing, because we're in reality. We're not in imaginary.
Yeah.
We're in reality.
Of imaginary.
And I don't believe that there's anything in here. The item box. No, nothing. Alright, come on. So right over here is kind of like the typewriter in Resident Evil, except it's a radio. Use the radio, even though it's like a projector.
Yeah. I think it's supposed to be a knob, but it looks like a projector.
Alright, so and this is how we can save the game, which is pretty cool.
QC.
Apparently, you don't need to have, like, ink ribbons. You can just come and save. So, there's an over right there, and that'll be fine.
Anybody out there? Can I save my card, QC? CQ. Whatever, I'm saying it backwards.
Alright, so, that was Meg's office.
Nobody knows.
Alright, so now we're going to do some running around, click around on a bunch more stuff.
Those cabinets. Have you seen how high the cabinets are? What, is she a midget? I'm sorry, a dwarf.
Healing jelly. So, got some more healing jelly. Nothing of note is here. Nothing of note.
Nah, you're in reality now. You got some healing jelly.
There are sinks in every lab.
Okay. Don't you know?
Light switch? It's a light switch. No use turning it off now, though. Fine.
Now she's telling you what to do.
Nothing seems to be of use. And then here's like this great big orange book right in your face.
Yeah.
Pick me up. Can you? No. It won't do nothing.
It's there for show.
No weapon, no matter where you stand.
Just sit it there randomly. The only thing that's not in any place.
So she said something. She was like, a data network and blah, 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 or something. And I accidentally canceled out. Because I gotta do this the whole time. Otherwise, you're gonna miss something. That's what ticks me off about games like this.
Take your time. Yeah, but she says it once, she'll never say it a second time.
Yeah. Alright, so what was she looking at? so there's a desk in the way. Alright. So check the map real quick just to see where we're at. And then we can get moving onward. Little square, that's where we're at, in the little square. Alright, so here's the door. We're going to go out the door then. Alright, so the door's right here. Time to get going.
Grumpy.
Excuse me.
It's me.
My name is Chris. Are you Meg?
Hello, Chris.
I'm Meg.
Oh, sorry. Meg Rain Man. It is a pleasure to meet you.
You don't have to be so formal. My pleasure to meet you. I know it's sudden, but the chief is asking for you. I'll guide you to the chief's office, if that's fine with you.
Oh, yes, it's fine with me.
You're acting so formal. Well, then, this way.
She's just pissed. She's like...
It's like, I'm surprised you don't have a cigar.
Now,
chief's waiting to see ya.
It's waiting to seize ya.
Ah! Stupid. Alright, so this is weird. So it's like, let's go this way. I want to see what's going on. Let's just glitch out, though. Look at that. Can I talk to her?
It's like a Talking Heads music video.
I want to talk to Chris.
He's the chief? He seems to be a rather burly man.
He can't be the chief. Oh. He's burly.
Yes, you should go introduce yourself now.
She's
just heaving.
Just shakes her head. Look at that, so you go that way, and what's it do? It freezes, cuts back.
Nice to meet you, Chief. I'm Meg Rainman. Sorry I was late, I'm at your services starting today.
Oh, thanks for coming. Looks like you're looking forward to getting to work.
I'm sorry we caused you so much trouble with this case.
What are you saying? We were the ones who were... You were serviced by Robert. It was a shame for him to end up that way. We have to go to work hard now, apparently. Make up for the lost time.
Yes, I think so too.
By the way, about Robert. You heard about three lab members, including him, that passed away.
Now it's three?
Passed away.
Yes, I heard that they all passed away at the exact same time.
That's right. Such an accident, there's a high chance that it was a virus.
I assume so. This is the CDC, after all.
Yes, this is the best facility against disease in public. For the public. No, I don't even know what to say.
Know the world?
No, the world!
Yes.
Okay. We are investigating on our own, but cannot figure out the cause of the death. However, the executives are fretful. So we want to make an explanation ASAP. Just now, the evacuation is in order, has been issued, whatever. Shutting everything down. Prohibited from leaving us from leaving the facility.
Now I want to rush through it, and I can't figure out what he's saying. I can't read that fast.
See, that's a problem. Like with games like this, is when you screw around with
Yeah.
When we're too busy doing that, it's like we fumble over the words and you don't get the story that's going on.
Yeah.
So it's like, no, we just need to sit here and be very serious about the game.
Yeah.
Take the game at a very serious tone.
Yeah.
Not even a game, it's a movie.
Prohibited us from leaving. That means...
Yes, we can't leave. Well, you could say that we've been quarantined.
Impossible.
I'm sorry about this happening on your first day. It's not that unusual for this facility. Well, the evacuation order is in the whole town. Rest assured, it will only be for 2 or 3 days.
Alright, I understand.
Fortunately, you are free to roam the facility and have a look around the place. Right now, we're checking for virus leakage from the basement, so you only see the second floor.
Alright.
Virus leakage. Then, Chris?
Yes? Yes. This is a card. It'll be your key for the identification of the facilities. Make sure you don't lose it.
Yes, I will be careful.
Then go around the facilities.
Yes, excuse me, man. Sorry, I said.
Whatever.
Tried. I'm gonna pass out now.
Alright.
His voice is hurt.
So now is the time for, like, exploration and dinking around.
The reference room doesn't open without a key. Yeah, explore. Yeah, explore around, Jake. It doesn't open without a key.
Alright,
explore, Jake.
If I go in here, that's the chief's office.
Yeah, go in there.
Okay. The cool thing is, like, with the door, when it opens up, you actually see what's in the room.
Hurry up and open the door.
Like,
no,
that.
That's nice. Nice transition.
Kind of like, what? No, you can't. He just gets mad at you.
What's wrong? Have you something to say?
No, I don't have anything in particular to say.
I see. You can get out of this room. I'm busy right now. You know.
Oh, I'm sorry. I wasn't sure which room to go to. I apologize. Excuse me.
Like, what if I do it again?
Do it. Just tick him off. Just tick him off. There's nothing in this new room I need to talk to the chief about. I'm just scared.
Alright, so here's the downstairs, which you can't go down.
Can't act?
The lobby is right downstairs. He said I could move around only on the second floor. It would be bad if I went downstairs.
Okay. So what's this? Room we can go
into. Wow. Okay, open the door. I don't know.
Oh, here we go.
Old professor.
Look at that.
What is she stuck on?
Like, I hate garbage like that. It's stupid.
Great Scott!
Doc Brown.
Oh my! There's a new face. I see. Are you Meg?
Oh, Meg Rainman. Nice to meet you. Today is my first day. I hope to do well.
I see. You're starting today.
Yes.
I've heard a lot about you from the from Robert. All I can say about Robert is that it was unfortunate. I hope you can figure out the reason soon.
I agree.
Oh yeah, the chief is helping us in trying to find the cause. So I'm sure you will know in due time. You can ask me if you are unsure of anything.
Yes, thank you very much. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Alright, so click around this room, see if there's anything.
Now I'm Professor Farnsworth. I slipped into Professor Farnsworth.
Who knows, everyone?
Can I call on the phone? No. Alright, let's see. What's over here?
I'm just jumping around. Like, I have walking problems.
Alright, I'm gonna check this closet. Nothing. Fine. It doesn't open. Alright.
Get the light switch.
Maybe I can talk to him again.
So it rotates.
I'm sorry, I'm a little busy right now.
Just stands there. I'm busy, and he sits there.
He's a small guy. What? Get your face out of there.
He's like bobbing doing? His head.
I'm a little busy right now. Yum. Yummy.
Doing okay down there, man?
Come on, baby.
Oh, that was fun.
Oh, okay.
You can stop.
So there's a light switch.
No use turning it off now, though.
Turn it off and then come over here. And don't.
Oh, man. Don't want to be alone in the dark with this old creepy man. Clock's all white now, so you can't tell.
And look at this.
Yay!
So you can attack. Push.
Here, do that to the old man.
We're gonna see if we can push the old geezer.
Oh, you can't.
Just goes right through them. See, that'd be funny.
Yeah.
Alright, so we're gonna get out of here. Alright, so the only other door is this one then.
Look at that, it's like a submarine.
Oh, what are these? More light switches or what? And look at her shadow.
Yeah, it's a monolith. Okay, thanks for freedom in this game. Probably just turn all dark and blue. Labor. The laboratory.
Look how slow she walks.
Carefully, carefully. Don't want to break a heel. Going to the laboratory.
Laboratory.
Laboratory. Identical to the It is the same room, it just doesn't have the curtains in it. It's the exact same room, but without the curtains.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. Alright. So let's see, let's go over here. This is one of those games, it's like you have to... Alright. You found the file, pick up. No, I made a mistake last time I played it. I hurried up and hit the buttons really fast and couldn't read it.
I heard the security guard suddenly died. It's true, I haven't seen him around lately. There is one rumor that bothers me the most. One rumor was that he died because he saw a strange 8mm film. I found the strange 8mm film in the reference room drawer and I watched it, but can it be that that was it? Afterwards, I felt bad from a prank But I don't know what's going on here. What is the letters off the box?
Yeah,
it's off letters
the
outside
box.
Of the box. Felt bad from a prank. But you can't kill someone with a movie. I showed Robert's group the 8mm film, but all that resulted was Robert enjoying it for some reason.
It's like he just got his jollies off.
It. It's like a snuff film or something. It is like a snuff film,
yeah.
Too. It's weird. He likes
fetish
horror movies.
Fetish video.
Probably. But he sure has weird tastes. Yeah, probably. I don't know why watching that footage makes him happy. I didn't feel like writing this diary, but I felt I had to. It's rather strange. I feel a little at ease now. I guess diaries are good once in a while. Okay, dear diary.
So you exited. Okay, so she took it, right?
Yeah.
Now, if I go back and I want to read that file to, like, re-catch up, okay, let's
make
sure.
Yeah, let's say you clicked through it and you didn't get to read it.
Okay, items.
Oh, read it later. No,
okay,
well,
S items.
Special items. Okay. What? Okay, card.
That's a card and a flashlight.
Okay, info? Nope. Nothing.
Too bad.
Absolutely nothing.
Too bad.
You missed it. You just missed it.
Alright, so.
You thought this was not a linear game.
It doesn't open without a key. Alright. So now we gotta remember
that
needs our key.
That pass key that you picked up, can you use that?
I think that pass key is for opening up a door.
I would think so too, but it's a weird thought. I mean, it's not like a great game. Go use. Just give it a shot. Dare ya. Sidums. Oh, you can't use. There's no option for use. It's
no.
Just info.
Alright. So, let's see what's going on here. Nothing at that desk. Let's check this one. It's like, why do you explore so much? Just get going. Because of stuff like that.
You have to. That's what this game is. It's all about exploring.
It's more like you're kind of casually going.
Oh, no. When did our audio stop? 30 minutes in. How far are we in on this game?
I'm not sure. About 40-something.
Great. I must have gotten excited and turned off our audio or our battery died. Probably our battery died.
Reload.
Well, it's still on. Fine. Can we keep playing from here?
Yeah, we'll just keep going.
What a mess. Well, we didn't miss
too much.
That happened
last week, too.
Yeah, it's like, what the heck? This game is cursed. The ghost did it. It reached out of our console and then just turned off our audio.
And that's the thing, though, with the game is, like, it's like watching a movie. Like, we're just playing through a cinematic movie.
Completely linear. So careless. So careless. So reckless. Everyone's reckless with her. There's that book again.
And these controls are just atrocious.
Yeah.
Very bad control scheme going on. All right.
Wow, a cabinet you can actually reach? It's not a million feet in the air?
Look at this. There's nothing here. There's a book.
Nothing
right
here.
There.
Nope, nothing here. Nothing here.
Won't click on it, won't nothing. There's nothing I need here. All right.
I just got tired of making the game detailed. So many chemicals, what to do with them?
What do they use them for?
So many chemicals, so little time.
All right, so can I go into here? It doesn't open. Fine. Let's get out of here then.
Big plus on the floor. This music, bum, bum,
Meg Rainman.
Meg Rainman Lab 1.
Meg Rainman Lab 1. Meg Rainman Lab 1. Meg Rainman Lab 1, you have a phone call. Meg Rainman Lab 1. You have a phone call, Meg Rainman Lab 1. Phone call, Meg Rainman Lab 1. Meg Rainman, return to your room and pick up your phone. Return to your room, Meg Rainman Lab 1!
A phone call for me? I wonder if it's Jack. I should get back to the lab. Here's the thing. Where is her room? Now, I do know that there is a map in the actual manual. But it's like, it's all like weird and goofy.
It's different from our map. It's sideways, too. Okay, so I have to find out where we are now. You just left one of the labs, but it doesn't say which number.
It's like they try to make it all like 3D, and it's like all goofy looking.
Yeah.
So, I don't know, if you want
to
take that,
map,
you can look
at
that.
Either our navigator.
Now, I don't think we can go back.
Reference, audio, visual.
If I remember right, like, her room was way down here, which is just goofy.
It's like they didn't really show you following. No, that's the bathroom. Okay, so you just walked past the men's restroom. You went to the end of the hallway, which is, it's weird, because there's all these doors in the hallway, which aren't even on this. In this is just one complete run all the way around. But no, there's all these doors in the way. So you got the women's locker room, the men's locker room. It's not even on the... There it is, okay. Keep going, and then you'll end up... No, I think you way past it. I don't even see it
here. Here it is.
Did you find it?
I think this is it.
It's research labs 1 and 2, 2 and 4. 2 through 4. Well, that's weird. Lab 1 is in research lab 2 through 4. Did I read this wrong?
All right, I'm going to answer the phone. Hello? Meg!
Oh, I see. It was the first door was
research. I heard that there's a possibility.
Oh, I heard there's a possibility of a virus. Oh, sorry. It's the top of the headline, blah, blah, blah.
It's only a possibility. They said it wasn't too uncommon around here, so don't worry.
You say it's uncommon. It's not uncommon.
Anyways, Jack, that ring you mentioned earlier, it was just a game.
That program booted?
I had no problems, and there could be no way that a computer program killed someone.
Nothing really happened. Nothing really happened?
Nothing. You worry too much. Although, speaking of something happening, I had a prank call right afterwards.
Prank call? Now he's the one asking all these questions.
Yes. And there was a weird word on the screen. A weird word.
A weird word? Like, weird word?
It said, bracket, dead bracket. I think it meant game over.
That's not too funny. That's not too funny.
Anyway, did you figure anything out?
That's a weird word. That's right. Apparently, Robert's body was handed over to the CDC. The
CDC? I wonder if it's to find out the cause of death. But now I guess I'll be able to find out directly. Thank you, Jack.
Don't go overboard. I'll call you again if I find anything. Talk to you later.
Yes.
Okay. So apparently Robert's body is here.
Robert.
Okay. Robert.
For now, I should ask the chief.
All right. So now, where are we going to go? Oh, back to good old Chiefy Poo's room.
In any case, they were the ones that Robert's body was handed over to. I know the chief is looking out for me still. I wish he had told me about this. Anyway, the first thing now is to go talk to the chief.
So this is pretty much what, like, a lot of the game is, from what I've already played.
Yeah.
It's just running
talking,
around.
Running, talking. Alright, so if you go down that way, you curve all the way back around the chief's offices, two lefts, and keep going forwards. Okay, sit and wait for her to figure out how to open a door. Keep going forward.
Oh, let's walk the whole time.
Yeah, that sounds like a great idea. It's like, yeah, that's how everybody walks in an office place. My bad back. No, just running like crazy. Okay, you took a first left. Another door. Like, what are you in, a sub? It's
lobby.
A submarine. Let's all go to the lobby. Okay, go forwards.
I know
past
where.
Past the stairs. I know, I'm just
You gotta study that map, though, yeah. Too, so you know.
And then, okay, to your right. The end on the right on the corner.
What are you doing here?
Yeah. It's gonna be pissed.
Just angry.
A bonsai tree in the corner. He just stands there. That's all he does. Do you want anything, Meg?
I'm sorry to bother you when you're so busy. I wanted to ask you something
staring
about
at
Robert.
The wall.
Bobbert.
About Robert? Did something happen with regards to him?
Yes. I heard that Robert's body had been handed over to this laboratory.
Robert's body?
Yes. If that was the case, I want to see him.
You want to see him? Meg? I can understand how you feel, but can you spare us? This is no playground. I have plenty of work other than Robert's case.
Yes. I know, but I wanted to look into it as well.
Even though that's what I hired you for, you're not responsible for him, Meg. There are many other specialists here at the CDC, not just you. Or can you not just trust any of them?
No, that's not how I meant it.
I
was just regretting what happened to Robert. I couldn't forget what happened. I know it's a personal affair, but I wanted to find out the truth firsthand. The police started rambling nonsense that a program called Ring was suspicious.
Meg, don't just know. I don't know what you heard from where, but I am busy. A computer program? I have no idea what you're talking about. You're getting in the way of some of my work. You get out of here and cool off your head in the lab.
You're hothead.
I can clearly say that you are not the same. Cool your hot head.
So he's getting ready to whack her. He just raises his hand to her. He's about ready to beat her.
Get back in the kitchen where you belong.
Make me a sandwich.
I'm sorry.
For mouthing off.
For mouthing off like that.
I'm out of love, Meg!
Meg!
Didn't you hear me get out of this room? Steam. Go cool off your head for a while!
Yes, I'm terribly sorry. I apologize for bothering you when you are so busy.
One,
it's like,
two,
like, what the heck is going on?
Three.
It'd be cool to actually, like, it'd be funny to make a movie like that. Like some sweet little girl.
Busy. I want to know what happens to Robert.
Bah!
Stupid.